Hello children, welcome to the English class. Today we are going to learn how to write an article. We are going to see what an article is, learn the format of an article, how to introduce, develop and conclude an article, and last of all we will see some points with which we must remember if we want to write a good interesting article. Now what is an article? An article is a piece of writing which we write because we want it published in a newspaper, magazine or a journal. It can describe an experience, event, person or place. You can present your opinions, that is what you think, provide information. You could even give suggestions or advice. Now let us look at the format of an article. An article should have a heading or a title, byline, introduction, body or main part, and last of all, a conclusion. Now let us look at the heading. It should be attention grabbing. It should catch the eye of the reader and make him want to read the article. It should be short, just a few words, a phrase or a proverb and not a complete sentence. And it should suit the topic you are writing about. It should be thought-provoking and should suggest the theme of the article. Now the next is byline, which should come just below the headline. It is the name of the writer who has written the article. It could even be at the end. For example, by : Rohit Sharma. Now if a name is given in the instructions, you are supposed to use that name, otherwise you use your name and surname. Introduction should attract the reader's attention and make him want to read further. It should be interesting. It should contain the highlights of the article. You could begin an introduction with an anecdote, a quote or a thought, slogan, fact, or even ask a question. An introduction is just one paragraph. The next is body or main part. And because it is the main part, you can have one or many paragraphs. It throws light on the topic, gives all the information you want to give. It could contain advantages and disadvantages of something, cause and effect, technical words, scientific language, etc. Now the next is the conclusion, which is the end. It has one paragraph only, provides summary, and it has to sum up the topic. You can't leave loose ends. You can end by giving a solution. You could ask a question to the readers, give a warning or express a hope. Now there are some very important points to remember when we are writing an article. Do not exceed the word limit. For you all, it is 120 words. Write the points in a logical order. What comes first has to be written first, and then the next one in the proper sequence. Sum up the topic properly. You can't leave loose ends. Do not use over emotional language. You have to use your imagination and be creative. And use words which are suitable, that is suitable vocabulary. And remember to divide your article into paragraphs, 3 or more. Now some topics on which you have to write articles. The first one, children are made to work in places where the conditions are bad. They are made to work for poor wages, little food and poor living conditions. Write an article in 120 words on child labor. The second topic for today, write an article on steps needed to stop global warming. Again, the word limit is just 120 words. Please write articles on these topics in your notebooks, keeping all the points discussed today. Keep all these points in mind and do remember to give a very interesting heading or title. That's all for today. Thank you, children. Take care. Stay at home. Stay safe.